The next thing we need to do, now that we know a little bit more about the structure of DNA, is figure out how to make more of it. One of the things we talked about in chapter 8 is how cell division requires a certain amount of DNA to be produced. And in order for that DNA to be produced, there's obviously a process, and DNA replication is it. So during the cell cycle, you have to copy the DNA, and you have to do it perfectly, because each of the new cells needs to have exactly the right amount of instructions. And the question then is, how do you do that? Well, it turns out that each of the two original DNA strands, remember this is a double helix, so you have two strands, each of these can serve as a template, and based on that template, you have a copy being made by something called DNA polymerase. DNA polymerase is an enzyme, and this enzyme basically runs along the DNA, it reads the information that's there, and then it attaches a complementary nucleotide as it reads the information. And if you do this, then one thing that happens that is entirely unusual when you make a copy of something is that an original piece of DNA, as well as a copy, gets passed onto each of the new cells. And that's why we call it replication. Now, it's called replication for a reason. This is a very specific mechanism. It is not like making a copy. Think about this for a minute. If you make a copy, what you do is you go to a photocopy, let's say, and you have an original, and you take this original and put it on the glass and hit copy, and then you end up with the original and with a copy, right? That's what you normally get. And so, in one hand you have the original, in the other hand you have a copy. That's great, but if you then take the copy to make a copy, and then that copy, and you make a copy. Copies of copies tend to lose resolution, and some of you may have received handouts from some of your instructors, and they've been copied, and copies may have copied over the years, and they don't look so good anymore. Well, that's what cannot happen with DNA. You can't have a piece of DNA go to the new cell and it just doesn't look good anymore. You actually have to have something that's perfect. So how do you do that? Well, in this process, that's why it's called replication rather than anything else, you actually are able to always keep an original with you and a copy. And that's kind of odd, but this is how it works. So you start out with the original DNA molecule, shown here in blue. That's the one from the parent cell, or the parental molecule in general. And you are going to create the daughter molecule, the so-called nascent strand, in gold here, by adding to the blue, to the original. Well, clearly, as you're cutting through this and you're producing more, you're going to end up with so many things, you're going to end up with this part in one new cell and this part in the other new cell. So if this is cell 1 and this is cell 2, you end up with a new piece of DNA and an original piece of DNA in that new cell. So this is how, in the case of replicating DNA, you carry with you a piece of the original and the new piece. You're not just dealing with copies. So when it comes to DNA, you're never truly just making copies of copies of copies, but there's always a piece of the original that you can refer to. And if this piece, the original piece, is faithfully replicated, then of course you end up with two functioning and two good pieces. Now how does this process work? Well, the process works by having the enzyme find a certain place along a chromosome, and that's where the enzyme can attach. These places are called origins of replication. And so here is an example for one area the origin of replication, and there is something on this sequence, the sequence of A's and T's and G's and C's, that identifies this to the enzyme as an origin area. So the enzyme can find this and begin its work. Now the enzyme will begin by opening up the DNA strand. Opening it up means actually disconnecting some of the hydrogen bonds. And after it's disconnected these, it can unravel the DNA and then move along the DNA as it unravels it and make copies. Now it's bidirectional, which means you can have another enzyme that does the same thing over here. And so when all is said and done, when production is done, you end up with two daughter strands, and as you can see here, each of them consists of part original and part copy. And that's the neat thing about DNA replication, because you never actually depend on only a copy. You always carry with you part of the original.